Hello everyone, welcome to Spine Education Channel. Today we'll be animating feathered serpent that I have rigged previously. I have streamed the full rigging process, so putting the link on the screen. To not miss upcoming streams, subscribe and hit that bell to get notified right away. And if you were following those streams, you might see that we have new wings rigged. Excited? Yes, exactly. This serpent will spread his wings in its all glory. But sadly not flying yet. Maybe in the next video. Okay, so basically this serpent will stand on its back two legs, spreading his wings and flapping them briefly. And at the end, simple landing will close the loop. Ah yes, we also have new addition, these red bones aligned along the spine path. We may use them to adjust the curvature in the animations, without altering the main bones. We also have some tiny improvements in the rig, but I will not cover them now. Instead, I will leave the project files in the description, so you can check them yourself. Before starting any complex animation, I prepare key poses in separate animation, to use them later as a reference. Normally, I don't use pose-to-pose approach unless the animation is super complex. Please don't take this as an advice, instead, pose-to-pose approach might be the right way in most cases. And combined with the Favor tool that comes with 4.0 version, you can speed up your workflow greatly. Okay, let's get started. After I find all desired poses, I go and find the timing that works for me. For that, I take the main bone, which is mostly the pelvis, but in this case it will be the chest bone. I animate it roughly, mainly focusing on the overall timing. Then I polish the curves. And separate X and Y axis, to add some offset between these timelines. That gives us nice curvy motion. Remember, this is not final. I will revisit this curve many times in the future, but the foundation will be the same. Now, let's animate the hips in a similar manner. And go right away to the head bone and do the same. Oh, let me unhide it quickly. And yes, you can see that we have the main movement that can be modified very easily using curves in the graph view. Just for visual comfort, I will also animate the leg to see how it balances on the feet. Finally, let's see how the wings are working with all this. Well, this is not final. Just quick blocking to finally reveal the main pose. Okay, here are the curves for the wings. Nothing to say honestly. I did a lot of adjusting here and there. A little offset of the tips of the wings. And that's it. The difficult part was actually the tail. Generally, with tails, I do some systematic smooth movements, like a cloth or a whip, or something like that. Mostly offsetting the timelines. But here, I want to consider the ground and animate it a little different. We have some not desired portion of the wings here. So I try to distract the eyes from the wings by making tail more active and interesting. And you know what? I ended up using Favor tool for real. And I like it. I feel like after some more practice, I will feel more competent to share with you my experience with the Favor tool. Now, let's check the final result. What do you say? Cool, right? I spent 4 hours on rigging, opening state of the wings and animating the whole bird. But the funny part is that I spent 2 hours to find those wings on internet. I mean, I had a lot of options to choose, but I was not sure about the pose of its left wing. Until one of our fellow animators, who also can draw, helped me out by pointing out the positions and correct connections to the body. Thank you. Hey, I still have a few minutes to go. Are you with me? Then here are 3 tips for you. First tip is when you select vertices with soft brush, you can deselect the single vertex by clicking on it, with Ctrl+Alt held on the keyboard. Next tip is when you change the origin point of the mesh and later want to reset it, just click on it. And if you are tired of auto-scrolling the tree when you click on the tree annotations, right-click on them. It will show the settings of the constraints right away. That's it. If you want to learn how to rig this bird, go watch the stream I did previously. I will put it on the screen. And if you really care about the content on this channel, please answer on this question in the comments. What I could have done better in this video to make it more useful for you. I feel like I'm showcasing my skills and not actually teaching you. Well, streaming the full process could work, but it is too long and very boring. So in general, what type of content you want to see more? Thank you for watching and special thanks to these fantastic people. They inspire me to create more content for you all.